prefer for more rope tricks. Bigger than I am.
Okay.
Apologies to George Sand, too, for that.
I accept.
We've asked Mr. Lind and Mr. Brown to remain with us on stage for the next presentation. The Ring and the Assembly have traditionally given recognition to a Valley of the Sun Magician of the Year, and this year is no exception. The state of Arizona, and in particular the Valley of the Sun, has an impressive number of professional magicians who make their home here but perform literally around the world. In selecting the Valley of the Sun Magician of the Year, we considered many worthy candidates. Narrowing down the selection was no easy task. Let me tell you a little bit about our 1997 recipient. First, he's a native of the Valley of the Sun. He began his fascination with the magical arts at the age of 7. By the age of 12, he had performed in more than a dozen states, Canada, and Central America. Over the years, his exceptional talents have provided him with the opportunity to perform for millions of people in 74 countries around the globe. He is seen live by more audiences than any other magician, with the possible exception of David Copperfield, but that's okay. Because many of the illusions featured in David Copperfield's show were originated by this man. He is considered to be one of the top three inventors of magic in the world today.
This evening's Magician of the Year also holds the highest award from the Academy of Magical Arts in Hollywood. In addition, he is recognized expert in the field of psychic research. At the request of Time magazine several years ago, he made a study of so-called psychic surgeons in the Philippines. His efforts culminated with testimony in court on behalf of the U.S. Federal Trade Commission to stop the promotion of fraudulent psychic healers in this country. He has long been associated with and makes many of his appearances in conjunction with the Campus Crusade for Christ International. He is so highly regarded by his fellow performers that his advice and assistance is sought after by the top professionals in the business.
He is also beginning a family dynasty of his own. His son, Tim, is one of the leading illusionists performing today, after, of course, having served his apprenticeship with his dad. Tim and Jenny Lind can be seen in top review shows around the world. They were recently featured on last month's NBC special, World's Greatest Magicians 4. Tim's father is himself no stranger to television, having appeared on television in all 50 states and in many countries all over the world. He was also featured on the network television series The Magician with Bill Bixby. Last month, daughter Stacy was crowned Miss Arizona and now goes on to compete in the Miss USA Universe pageant. We'll all be rooting for her on March 10th, 1998 in Louisiana.
By now, of course, you know that our 1997 winner of the Valley of the Sun Magician of the Year award is Andre Cole. David Copperfield says of Andre, quote, "I not only consider Andre Cole to be one of the greatest illusionists in the world today, but his deep personal faith in God has been a great inspiration to me, as well as millions of people throughout the world."
Andre Cole has also served the magical societies in this community with distinction. A past president of Ring 55, he has lent his name and celebrity to Magic Society public shows, conventions, and fundraisers without hesitation. Indeed, he answered the call to lend his assistance in making this evening a memorable event with his presence. We are always grateful for his support, and whenever and wherever he performs, he reflects glory on his hometown. He serves as an inspiration to magicians everywhere, and we are pleased to recognize his accomplishments. Now, to add his comments about our 1997 Magician of the Year, here again is Mr. Jack Brown.
I just want to say it's an absolute pleasure to be part of this fitting tribute, and it's all been said. I don't have anything to add except I'm just glad to be a part of it. Thank you.
Also, Lauren Lind would also like to say just a few words about
Andre. Several years ago, I had the pleasure of attending a wonderful magic show at Lake Tahoe. There was a young pole on the bill, so I saw Tim performing early on his career. And as a father of three sons, I know how very proud Andre must be of having a son doing the things that he loves as much as he loves to do himself. It's a real pleasure to be here tonight. I with you congratulate Andre on a wonderful, wonderful magical existence in life and for raising a great family. It's just a
And now to receive his award, would you please welcome Mr. Andre Cole. Everybody knows what it says. Assembly number 248, Society of American Magicians, the Jack Sutherland Assembly, and Ring 55, International Brotherhood of Magicians, the Bird Easley, Danny Du Ring, hereby proclaim and award 1997 Valley of the Sun Magician of the Year to Andre Cole. Whereas Andre Cole performs all over the world, and whereas Andre Cole is an internationally recognized inventor of illusions and magical effects, and whereas Andre Cole is consultant to many of magic's top professionals, and whereas Andre Cole represents the finest ideals in magic, and whereas we are proud to claim him as one of our own, we are pleased to award him 1997's Valley of the Sun Magician of the Year Award, awarded this 16th day of December 1997 from Ring 55 and Assembly 248.
Congratulations, Andre. We're looking forward to your performance tonight. And now to present our last award for this evening, here again is your MC, Mr. Brad Z. Yeah!
All right. Are we up here?
No.
Check, one, two. Check, one, two. There we go. Thank you very much. Lots to do, ladies and gentlemen. Well, now we come to a very, very special point in our program this evening. For those of you who are regular attendees at our annual holiday banquet, you are aware that Ring 55 and Assembly 248 bestow a lifetime achievement award each year. Sometimes, even two of them. Some of the honorees in the past have included John Smith, Carl Langdon, Bob Cavanaugh, and George Sands, just to name a few. Tonight, we're pleased to add a name to that list whose lifelong contributions to magic are truly remarkable. As a matter of fact, there are two honorees this evening. The committee decided that it was a tie, and no one was willing to break that tie. Furthermore, if we've been successful so far, we have kept this honor a complete surprise to our recipients. Joe, may I have the envelope, please? Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, this year, SAM Assembly 248 and IBM Ring 55 present the Lifetime Achievement Award to Ed and Nancy Keener. Before we ask the Keeners to join us on stage tonight to receive their award, I'd like to take a few moments to tell you something of their lives in magic. It is a story. Of adventure, friendship, and love. The story begins like most. A young man in the fourth grade in Indiana sees his first magic effect. In this case, the steel ball and tube. Instantly, he was hooked. He began to read all he could on the subject and went to see every magician performing in his area. He began to invent magical effects of his own, and today, at the age of 74, he still reads all he can, sees everyone he can, and still invents magic. After schooling, Ed entered the service and performed with special services in the Army. Then it was on to the desert Southwest. In Phoenix, he secured a position as assistant manager for Sears Department Store. During his 14 years at Sears, Ed met and fell in love with his lifelong assistant and soulmate, Nancy. Nancy was attending cosmetology school. They gave their vows in Las Vegas in 1952, and 1997 marks their 45th year of marriage. Nancy's family lived in Las Vegas, and it was during the long road trips between Phoenix and Las Vegas that they began to toss around ideas for a new and original act. At that time, no one was doing much in the way of magic with balloons. Ed invented the shooting a silk into a balloon, as well as many other effects that made their act truly unique and eventually the envy of magicians worldwide. They perfected the act through countless hours practicing in their living room after having worked their regular jobs all day. They were rewarded with two bookings on the famed and prestigious It's Magic Show at the Wilshire Evil Theater in Los Angeles. They appeared with Chang and Harry Blackstone Sr. They also performed on the Light Magic Show in Santa Barbara. This was the fabled Santa Barbara convention that featured Phoenix IBM Ring 55, then known as the Mystic 13. Phoenix walked off with all but two of the convention trophies given away that year. Ed found time along the way to serve as president of Ring 55 and was the last charter member of Hollywood's famed Magic Castle. He holds Magic Castle number 150. In the early 60s, Ed and Nancy found a new theme park was opening here in the Valley. It was called Legend City. There, they polished their act 4 to 5 times a night, 6 nights a week for many months. Also on that show was a female ventriloquist who went on to become Miss America in 1965. Perhaps you remember Vonda K. Van Dyke. When Ed and Nancy returned to the States in 1980, Vonda K. remembered them with fondness and sent along this book of her poetry with her best wishes inscribed inside. As we may have mentioned a little earlier, Vonda was a student of Don Seth. Ed and Nancy are not easily forgotten. It's just part of their magic. 1964 saw the Keeners gain national exposure on the Steve Allen Show with Jane Mansfield. That led to the Hollywood Palace TV show with Roy Rogers and Dale Evans, Kate Smith, and others. Marvin and Carol Roy, better known as Mr. Electric and Company, were in Europe at that time, and they encouraged the Keeners to cross the Atlantic as work was more plentiful on the continent. The Lido show in Paris saw their act, liked it, but they requested they finish with a dog instead of the parrot that they were using. And that's how Bianca became the third Keener. On May 10, 1965, the Keeners put their furniture in storage and left for 6 months of speculative work in Europe. They ended up staying for 21 years. They worked the first 5 years without a day off, except for traveling. Their dreams to see the world and work steadily were now coming true. They worked all the exclusive nightclubs, theaters, and resorts in Germany, Spain, England, and the Middle East. They were seen on all the big television shows in Britain. They appeared at Churchill's nightclub in London 7 times for 6 months at a time. They appeared in 34 countries from Russia to Finland to Africa, including two command performances for the King and Queen of Iran and a command performance for the King of Sweden. By the time they left Europe, they had performed the act 7,621 times. Let me repeat that, 7,621 times. When you divide that by 364 days in a year, you get 21 years of nonstop work, and they could have stayed longer. But Ed and Nancy wanted to return home to be with their family in Las Vegas. They performed many times upon their return, including a tour with their dear friend, Andre Cole. Finally, in 1989, they left home one more time to perform in Japan. It was to be their farewell tour, and the last time they performed the act, known as Magic of the Atmosphere. In tribute to the lasting nature of their contributions to magic, last month, Ed and Nancy were inducted into the Order of the Dragon at an elaborate ceremony at the Magic Castle in Hollywood. For those of you unfamiliar with the Order of the Dragon, let me just say that it is among the most exclusive and prestigious honors one can achieve in the world of magic. I'm sorry, thank you so much. Thank you.
Only a handful of the world's greatest magical couples have been so honored, and all new inductees are nominated and voted upon by the previous winners. Tonight, Ed and Nancy, we wish to honor you once again by presenting you with another very exclusive recognition, the Lifetime Achievement Award from Assembly 248 and Ring 55. Now, I'm giving you the facts about Ed and Nancy, and that's more than enough to warrant this special recognition, but there's another dimension to the Keeners that must be mentioned here tonight. To all those that know the Keeners and to their many friends throughout the world, the Keeners are highly regarded for their personalities. They are, very simply, wonderful people. Over the many years of their magical life, they have quietly gone out of their way to help others. The innumerable acts that they have worked with around the world were often the beneficiary of their generosity. Many times they loaned money, food, and clothing to performers in need, and never once did they expect anything in return. Indeed, the Keeners were simply putting something back into the business that they love and that loves them. Performers the world over still call Ed and Nancy to thank them for making a difference in their lives when they needed a helping hand. The Keeners are among a rare breed of people. They are pros, and they've earned every inch of that title. Ed and Nancy have paid their dues. They played the small slabs and then successfully graduated to the big time. And when they came home, they returned triumphant, and never once did it go to their heads. As I have known them, and others will quickly attest, they are still the decent, honorable, humble, generous people that began their journey over four decades ago. They possess that certain something that you cannot buy or pretend to have. You either have it or you don't. And they have it in spades. They have class. They also have a deep and abiding love for each other. They are inseparable. You cannot think of Ed without thinking of Nancy, and you cannot think of Nancy without thinking of Ed. Their knowledge is a treasure. Their company is a distinct pleasure. And we pray that they'll be with us for a long time to come. When I had the honor of mastering the ceremonies for the Danny Dew Testimonial Banquet many years ago, I wrote the biography of Danny and Melba Dew. Now that was quite a night. The room was filled with magical luminaries, much as it is tonight. And I concluded my remarks with a line that I borrowed from the old film. Since then, I noticed that someone else thought it was a good line too, and used it this past year to eulogize Harry Blackstone Jr. I didn't mind, really. It was a very good line. And since I've never been known to fail to use a good line when I hear it, I am tonight reclaiming it for the award to the Keeners. In the 1939 MGM musical, The Wizard of Oz, the Tin Man makes his request to the Wizard for a heart. The Wizard, or Professor Marvel, tells the Tin Man that a heart is judged not by how much it loves, but by how much it is loved by others. Ed and Nancy, your hearts are judged to be very big indeed, for as tonight proves, you are loved very much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you'll direct your attention to the monitors in the room, we would like to show you just a few selected minutes of the Keeners at work on German television.
Visiting dignitaries to join us for photographs at this time, so we'll do the best we can to get everybody up here. Mr. Lynn, Mr. Brown. Yeah. We did the best we could to get an autographed poster for you, a little souvenir of this evening. And if anyone didn't get a chance to sign it, see Ed and Nancy afterwards, and please feel free to add your signature to it. All right. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Ed and Nancy Keener. Go ahead. Say a few words. Yeah.
I never say very much, but to all of you in Phoenix, we're very, very humble, because this is our beginning. This is where we started. We started here as young kids with Andre and Alvina and Bert and Danny and all those guys, and we were just snowing, and they helped us so much. And we started here with Don Sapp and all the kids. And whatever we achieved by being a part of you. And we thank you all so much. So you're awesome.
I do thank you all very much. And for the younger fellows, when I got in the club in the early 50s, we had some old-timers, you know, Bert, Danny, Seth, others. And I listened and I watched, and I built until I could use the club sort of as a springboard to hire and better things. So all of you, you've got old timers, I guess I'm one of them now, in the club that can teach you, and you listen to them and learn and use your club as a springboard to whatever you want to achieve in the club. I thank all of you very, very much.
We'd like to present to you from Ring 55, International Brotherhood of Magicians, Assembly 248, Society of American Magicians, hereby proclaim an award, Lifetime Achievement, to the Keeners, the Magic of the Atmosphere. The Keeners' lifetime of performing artistry, creativity, and professional ethics have served as a superior example to the world of magic. They have served as international ambassadors of goodwill and the finest traditions of the IBM and the SAM. Their act, Magic of the Atmosphere, continues to serve as a benchmark of excellence in innovation and entertainment. Having achieved the highest standards of personal and professional attainment, their place in magical history is assured. Awarded this 16th day of December, 1997. Congratulations have been pouring in from around the world. Peter Ravine called us to tell us that was when he was introducing the Keeners in Victoria, he was out front much like I am, and behind the curtain and he suddenly heard pop, 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 pop. And then he heard stall, stall, stall. So the Keeners, from Peter Ravine, he sends his love and congratulations. Now, those of you that know Leo Behnke, you will appreciate this. It's a telegram, and I quote, "It only takes 10 words to congratulate the two Keeners, Leo and Pat." From Marvin and Carol Roy, "Ed and Nancy, what can I say? My timing was lousy. Ask Brad. Love you both mucho, Marv and Carol." Did you hear what happened to Carol? She ran into a dancer backstage, or actually a dancer ran into her, knocked her silly. She's okay now, but it was quite a go there. From Mac King, "Dear Ed and Nancy, well, it's only been since our recent move to Las Vegas that Jennifer and I have gotten to know you two. It seems like we've been friends for years. I think that's because you're both such sweet, down-to-earth people. It is a hopeful sign for the future to see someone like you, Ed, who still has the same enthusiasm and zeal for magic as a fellow just beginning to be interested in it. I'll never forget the first time we came to your house and there you were practicing a new version of Wild Card. Such a refreshing change from so many show business veterans who become jaded and cynical. And Nancy, you're the same way. The way you raved about the acts you had on videotape that you wanted us to see was invigorating. I know very few people still so happy and contented about their lives and jobs. I hope to follow in your footsteps one day. Congratulations on your honor. Your pal, Matt King." All right, from Johnny and Pam Thompson, "We first met in the mid-60s on the Hollywood Palace TV show. Although you told me it was very early in your career, it was a real treat to see you perform an act that was so well-themed. Congratulations on being honored for your lifetime of magical achievement. See you back in Vegas, Johnny and Pam." And from Robert Gallup, this is a very special letter, all the way from Melbourne, Australia. "I would like to wish you both my heartfelt congratulations in recognition of a lifetime of achievements in magic. Not to diminish the importance of your major achievements, of which there are many, I would like to thank you both sincerely on a personal note for something by comparison you may think trivial but has left a significant impression on me and has proven invaluable on my career path. As a little rugrat magic kid, you always had time to invite me for a meal and share your infinite wisdom and insight into the real world of show business. Your candid and often harsh insights taught and prepared me for more for my career journey than any magic book or lecture. Anyone can herald the virtues and glories of show business, but a true friend prepares you for the rejection and disappointments and arms you with the knowledge and encouragement to persevere. I would be fortunate to influence only one person as you have influenced me. Yet you have spent a lifetime inspiring, teaching, and preparing an entire generation of magicians. You're a true friend to magic, and to magic congratulates your achievements and thanks you for your friendship. Eternally grateful, Robert Gallup. If we may, we've also received a short greeting on videotape from a man I think most of you will recognize. Can we roll it, please? Billy McComb.
Billy McComb here. I'm glad you and Nancy are being honored at this paper. And they said, you know, just say something. Well, one thing I can say is, do you remember way back, I was working with Playboy Club in London, and you were working Churchill's Club, and I'd worked there, so I knew the management. And I discovered an amazing thing, and that was we had one of the bunnies, Harvey, she came from Phoenix, big, strapping girl, a bunny called Harvey, yeah? And Harvey said, many years ago, I used to babysit for a magician called Ed Keener. Now, I knew you were working Churchill's Club, but I didn't tell Harvey. So I phoned Churchill's Club in London, where I worked off on Bond Street, and I got hold of Lou Lane, who was the booker of the place, and I said, tell Ed and Nancy I want them to come round to Playboy Club as my guest. It's very important, they should be there. So when you finished the show, if you remember, you came round to Playboy Club and we sat you down, but we sat you at one of Harvey's tables, the woman who babysat for you many months before. And she went up to the table and she said, I'm your bunny, Harvey. Jesus! Like that. And it turned out that she was seeing you for the first time in like 20 years. And then, as you know, the bunnies weren't supposed to talk to customers, so I pushed you off in my dressing room, and you and Harvey and Nancy all chat at least small hours. And I just want to wish you all the very best. You've been a wonderful performer over the years. I still remember how you changed the whole cup and ball routine because Carl Hamian gave you the aluminum cups, and you did the cups and balls, and you practiced it with the aluminum cups, which of course are a hell of a lot lighter than the ordinary cups you've been using. You had to change the entire routine. And I remember too, when you did the blocks, you know, the number of blocks, that is one hell of a thing. I could never do that because you've got to keep your head about you, and I'm not too good at doing that. Anyhow, my love and fondest regards to you and Nancy, and I wish you all the very best for maybe many, many more years to baffle us with your magic. And this is Billy McComb saying over and out.
Now, this is a very special year for a lot of reasons. Some of you may have missed the cosmic and profound magical significance, and we can go ahead and remove that now. Thank you. Some of you may have missed the significance of the coincidences in the numbers 50 and 5 this year. Let me try to play Martin Gardner for just a moment and enlighten you. In the year 1997, this is the 50th anniversary of IBM Ring 55. This is the 50th anniversary of Easley Sponge Shop. Doug Henning turned 50 this year. Tonight, the 16th, is Bertie Easley's birthday. Coincidentally, one from 6 equals 5. The shop's address contains both a 5 and a 50, 509 West McDowell. The Bert Easley Danny Do ring number is comprised of a 50 and a 5. The name Danny has 5 letters. This is the 5th anniversary of SAM Assembly 248. If you add the numbers 2, 4, 8 together, you get 14. If you add 1 and 4 together, you get 5. This is the 75th anniversary of the IBM International. This is the 95th anniversary of the SAM. This is the Keeners' 45th wedding anniversary. They performed their act 7,621 times. If you subtract 21 from 76, you get 55. Andre Cole will perform in his 75th country of the world as soon as they can find one on the map. There were 5 awards presented here tonight. There are 5 acts on the show bill here this evening. And coincidentally, the show is 5 hours long. Some members of the local magic societies have phone numbers or license plates that end in 5 or 50. Some have birthdays on the 5th of the month. Terry Godfrey and I were both born on the 15th of this month. I turned 40 this month. Terry turned 38. If you add 4 plus 0 plus 3 plus 8, you get 15. Okay, the last item's a little lame, but I just wanted to mention my birthday in here somewhere. But most importantly, we have just received word backstage that the National Park Service has estimated the crowd here this evening at 5 million people. All right. Now, I had something else I wanted to do at this point. I can't seem to remember what it was. It had something to do with a gift of some kind, and I can't quite remember what it was. Give me just a moment. I'm getting an image now.
Here comes Santa Claus,
ladies and gentlemen, what would the holidays be without this holiday? Hey! Santa, how are you? Good to see you. Very fine. Hot, tired, and...
Overworked,
yes. But this is your busy time of the year, too, I guess.
Well, more or less. Oh, wait a minute. We need a mic. Oh, why should this be different than the rest of the show? No.
There we go.
There we go. If you add together the number of times the microphones haven't worked, with the number of miscued videos, it's 55! I'm just kidding, Brad, because it's so darn easy. How you been, Brad?
Very tired. Ask me in another hour and I'll let you know if they haven't killed me by then.
Well, I'll tell you what, they may kill you before that. Right? They've seen your act.
I
wanted to come out here because, of course, a lot of you folks work in special costumes, like the ones you're wearing now, and you don't think anything about the fact that you need to have things hidden. Oh, Jimi Hendrix, 1968. Yeah, that was a burrito I had earlier. Brad, come back. Don't run away. I heard you. I was circling outside while you were doing the endless tribute to the Keeners. And I know they deserve it. They're really nice folks. But you know, I think you forgot the one thing that every magic show needs.
Oh, what's that?
That's a silk production. Here, try that. Well, it's not really silk, but it's a handkerchief. If you're going to be crying anymore, he's going to need one. Yeah. Well, you gotta wash it first, though. I never have. All right. Well, thank God. Give Brad a hand. It's the only one he'll get tonight. They wanted me to drop by and bring some of my special gifts. And that was kind of what I wanted to do. You know, we have a lot of things that are new every year. And then you have the Tickle Me Elmo, the Sleep and Snore Ernie, the lie and cheat, well, we won't go into that. Anyway, you can fill in a name you like there. I'll wait, that guy back there is still laughing. I want to bring a few of my favorite presents along because these all have to do with folks in the magic community. And you guys are looking like something's going to pop out of the bag. Come on, I don't work that way. I'm coming, here we go. Here we go. This is good stuff. I got a smaller bag in here. This is my waterproof bag. This is one here. Where's Mike Finney? Where, Finney, you out there somewhere? Yell out, you weirdo.
Yeah.
There you are. Hey, Finney, you know you do all of that lame stuff about the little tiny bag of peanuts? Look, little tiny Coke can. But it's better than that. Watch, when you push the button. That's for you, Finny. Where's Steve Michaels? Where's that guy? They don't usually let him in the front door. Where is he? Hey, where are you?
He's in the back.
There he is. He's back there doing table magic. That's amazing. No, he's always talking about he needs a special PA system of some kind that he can use when he's doing walk around. So I thought I'd get him a special miniature PA system. And it plays the only music that he can dance to. Brad Zinn, you know, Brad only has one really bad habit. All right, well, two. And you ever notice the guy's always smoking? Michael, shut up! That's the problem about working with props. They just won't be quiet. Here's one for Brad. He'll like this. A little tiny cigarette package. Where's John Smith? He's a famous guy here. John, where are you? You're hiding out. You're related to some guy that's into really heavy-duty computers. I got the world's smallest mini computer for you here. And, oh, by the way. Okay, you just want to leave the door. You got me. All right. Oh, man, this is dying, Brad. I told you this was going to be dying. When in doubt, blame him. Hey, you guys, do you want to have a really big-time career like the Keeners and all these other famous people? Here you go. You buy your own slot machine, and then you do this. We call this the Lance Burton starter set. Okay. Oh, wait, this is a good one here. This is what Claudia Schiffer got for, what's his name? Copperhead, that's right. It's a mirror to look at him because he's so pretty. But in case he's all by himself and there's nobody there to really appreciate him, when you open up the mirror. Gosh, this is the last one. Where's Blumley? Where's he hiding out? Big Bob, hey, we got something for you so you can step into the 20th century, bud. Cell phone. You'll like this. This is made by the Collector's Workshop. and it's made with a special feature that only has call waiting that you can call on. So it'll work for you. Listen, it's for you, Bob. All right, there you go. Now, I got one more. Kill the drummer. Would somebody just shoot him? Now, I got one more thing here that's the most important part of what I'm here for, and this is what I'm excited about. You don't want to mess things up. I got lists everywhere, and they gave me this one to make sure I get it right. This is it. I got one more gift I'm going to deliver to you. This is one I know you'll all enjoy, unlike the ones that I brought earlier. This is an internationally award-winning gift of music and jazz and magic. They've appeared with stars such as Lou Rawls, and they've been featured on the prestigious It's Magic show in Hollywood. They've been seen on television, cruise ships, and they're first place winners of the stage and showmanship trophy from the PCAM. In addition, NHK, the Japanese Broadcast Association, voted them the best act for TV. And Ed and Nancy, they wanted to be here to help pay their respects to you. So here they are from Las Vegas. Let's give a huge welcome to the magic and illusions of Victor and Diamond.
the last child of the suffering one that dies in the heaven, the wind from heaven above. But I'm just a baby in the business of earth. I must be like a waiter in all the time. That is the pain that a man like that won't have. That is the stuff. I'm just a baby in the business of love. There's nothing too good.
try this, okay? Well, I want to thank you guys for that wonderful warm welcome there, but they told me I was supposed to roast. Toast. Yeah. Okay. Ed and Nancy have been very, very close to us. They got a chance to, I got to meet them back in the early 80s. And I was a young man. Didn't think I knew it all, but I thought I was pretty smart. And I was wearing a white tuxedo, so I'll never forget this. And Ed came up to me and said, you know, handle those cards very well. But I couldn't see them against your white tuxedo. And that was smart. I said, man, I didn't think of that. You know, here I was thought I looked good. And this man picked out the littlest thing. It was the biggest thing in the entire act. No one could see the cards. And that was the beginning of a friendship that I know will last forever. I also got a chance to work with them on their very last show in Japan. And that was great, too. We're neighbors. We live in Vegas. And I get to see them a lot. And it was really tough because we're so close that when I was in town, this was supposed to be a surprise. I could not go over to the house. I knew I was going to spill the beans. So I wanted to stay away as possible. When Brad called me and told me that the beans were already spilled, I said, well, okay, I can go over now. But tonight is to honor two of the greatest people that I've known. And Diamond and I, we love you both. See you back home.
Victor and Diamond will be appearing at the Society of American Magicians National Convention, July 8th through 11th, 1998 in New Orleans. So get your reservations in early because I'm sure Lauren Lynn would love to see you there down in New Orleans, down in Jay's old hometown, Jay Malbro. This time, I'd like to ask everyone to get out your raffle tickets, and Herb, if you'll come up, we now have some prizes to give away. And we can get the house lights up in just a moment. Yes.
I have my granddaughters Ashley and Samantha. Samantha is sleeping. She's good here. Ashley, this young lady that was up here helping Victor with his magic trick is Bert Easley's great granddaughter, Ashley Murphy, and she's going to help me here. I'm going to, do you have any tickets?
Second.
You do? Okay, then you can't put tickets on the trunk. No, I thought you said they were your tickets. Yeah. Your dad's tickets. Well, I'm going to get you to go over and get the raffle drum over there with the tickets.
Here we go. It's coming to you.
Oh, very nice of you. Thank you.
Big time, folks.
Speaking of coincidences and the words 55, or the numbers 55, we have five door prizes tonight. The gentleman out here in the red and white suit had a 55-inch waistline. Our first door prize tonight, this is for a pair of tickets. There's a ticket in the large vanilla envelope there, Brad. Large vanilla envelope underneath there.
Yes.
As a certificate, thank you very much. The certificate, one of these certificates, the first one for tonight is a pair of tickets to a Phoenix Coyotes home hockey game. It's set up here so you can call the Phoenix Suns, and the number and the gentleman your contact is listed here. They can set you up with virtually any game you'd want to see during the next 4 to 6 weeks. So if you would please, let's draw the first ticket for tonight. The first winning number, please, is 521997. 997.
Yes.
And we have a winner back here in the back. Maybe I get a list of the help of Debbie to run that back. Could you please? Daughter Debbie will be my runner here. Thank you. Our next ticket, please, Ashley. This will be for two tickets to a Phoenix Suns home game. Again, you can make your arrangements through the Suns offices. The winning ticket is number 918. 918, right here. Okay. Thank you. Our next drawing. Our next drawing is for a one-hour psychic reading by Miss Bree. Now, the ticket number here is 880.
Oh, that would be
880. Okay. A pair of books here, the Paul Harris Volume 1 and 2, Art of Astonishment. This, strangely enough, through Easley's Punch Out. The winning number 2060. $100 value. Hope you enjoyed our Dr. Stern Bergman. Happy birthday! Through the gracious generosity of Mr. Larry Becker, we have a communion chest, a retail value of $169.50, I understand. I hope whoever wins this enjoys it very much. The winning number 1931. Right here, 1931.
Yay!
All right, and Herb, we have a couple of bottles of Spumante.
Oh, all right, this is an added bonus.
An added holiday bonus.
Unadvertised special.
Unadvertised special.
065, the last three numbers. 065.
Oh, hi, we're so happy. Congratulations.
Enjoy.
Is there any way that was fixed? Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay.
And our last prize for the night, 082.
082 in the back. All right, we'll get it to you.
And the winner of the person was the one, the Suns tickets. We have the certificate right up front here. Thank you, Jack. We thank you, folks, and I'll turn the program back over to Brad Zinn at this time. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Herb, usually one shot. Give him a nice hand, folks. And work very hard to get this prize. All right. We are drawing quickly to a close here, but we have one very, very special treat for you left. Before we bring this evening to a close, I'd like to thank a few people that worked very hard to make this all happen. First, I'd like to thank the governing board and officers of the Ring and the Assembly. All of the members of the governing boards and officers of the Ring and Assembly, would you please stand and be recognized? Have a few technical things to thank. First of all, giving up his evening to run Follow Spot, Steve Nathanson. Our invitation from Ron Wilson. Our state managers, Michael Nolan and Joe Sturbins. Our video operators, Steve Michaels and Jim Hunsinger, stand by. Our photographer, Pat Holcomb. Staff of the Doubletree Gateway Center, And the video graphics that were shown tonight were done by Nolan Imaging Studios and donated to us. It was about $1,000 worth of graphics or better. And I want to thank Michael for being here. Also, I want to thank personally my co-chair this evening, Mr. Mark Strivings. Thank you, my friend. President Dr. Blankiston, Robert Bumley, for all he has done, his sincere efforts in bringing our dignitaries here and his advice, guidance, and counsel. I won't forget. Thank you very much. Also, and, although we've had a little bumpy night, a little bumpy ride here, she has done a terrific job and really hung in there for me, my wife, Miss Brenda. Thank you very much. And finally, I want to thank the IBM and SAM dignitaries who made a special effort to be here tonight. You've honored us with your presence, and we invite you to come back and see us again very shortly. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to tie a big bow around tonight, you know who's next. House lights out, please. 2, 3, 4. To tie a big red and yellow ribbon around the old oak tree. Somebody get me a gun, I'll get it. House lights, please. Okay, all right. What a well-oiled crew we got here. All right. Kill them, kill them, kill them, kill them. One more. Oh, okay. We're working on it. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this is very special. Andre Cole and Company.
Through the years, it has been my custom to just perform my own creations, but recently a good friend, Don Wayne, created a very interesting illusion that I thought you might enjoy. So here's a little something that I call Crazy Lady. Through the years, Ed and Nancy Keener have been some of my closest friends, And I agreed to do this program tonight because I knew that they secretly were honoring him. So it was a big shock as I was listening backstage expecting to hear the comments about Ed and Nancy and trying to figure out what's going on. And by the time they got to saying that Tim was son, I began to realize that something sneaky had been pulled off on me. So it was a very big surprise, and I thank you very much for the honor that was shared with me tonight. Along with the Phoenix. Thank you very much. Ed, Nancy, and myself, we started our careers in magic together, and a lot had to do with the fact that every month we try and come up with some new magical effect that we could present at the Mystic 13, the IBM ring at that time. And it was through that exercise that had a great impact upon each one of our careers, our creativeness. And through the years, they have truly been, I've been their greatest fan. But right now, I'd like for you to meet one of my biggest fans. Thank you. was really cool. As I mentioned a little earlier, that my relationship with Ed and Nancy went way, way back. And in thinking about them, I'd just like to share with you one memory while they were setting stage for the final illusion. As I mentioned, we used to try and create new illusions all the time. And then we decided one year in 1955 that we'd go to the Magical Convention, the Pacific Coast Association of Magicians. They had a number of contests. So we decided that we would go over there and enter those contests. And I entered in a couple. And even though I don't smoke, I remember I taught Nancy some manipulation with cigarettes, and my future wife had taught her another act, and Ed had an original effect that he was going to present. So we didn't have much money at that time, and so we had a little luggage trailer, and we drove over with the equipment, and we only had enough money to buy one room, so we put the two girls in the one room, and Ed and I slept in the little square luggage trailer. But there were 8 trophies that year, and we came back with 5 of the trophies. I won a couple, and my future wife, and Nancy, and Ed all won trophies that year. So it was a great experience and a very precious memory. But when we got back, my father had one of these old 8mm projectors, not projectors, but cameras that you wind up. And so we took a little film of Nancy and Ed in the backyard, and it's just a couple minutes long, and you know you have to wind it up and run it and keep stopping. But we thought you might like to see that. It's only 2 minutes, and by that time we'll be ready for our final illusion. So here's a little bit of the young Keeners back in 1955, right after we got from the PCAM convention. Did we have right there? We were just driving over, and that was the backyard. Nancy, red hair at that time. Here was the effect that I think that Ed won his trophy with. It's a very, very clever illusion that fooled many, many magicians. And we did have to, it's no edit. This is actually the way it looks when you have something that go right through. With the two trophies for each other. Well, in closing, I'd like to present just one final illusion, one of the classic illusions from our shows that we presented in over 70 countries of the world. And the introduction to it usually went like this. As I traveled throughout the world, I tried to be on the lookout for things that I thought would be of interest to my audiences here in America. Since 1968, I have made 4 different tours throughout various parts of India. On each one of those tours, whenever I had any spare time, I devoted part of my time to investigating the possibility of levitation. Right now, I'd like to present something for you that goes beyond anything that I witnessed in India or any other part of the world. So I hope that you will enjoy what I believe to be one of the most beautiful illusions ever created. So from this point on, there's very little to be said, but much to be seen.
Thank you.
think magic is alive and well here in Arizona for a long time to come. I'd like to thank several people. Oh, before we do, we had a snafu. I want to apologize. We'd like to present, where is Agnes Lynn? Agnes, thank you very much for being here tonight. These are for you. And to Carol and Debbie from Easley's Fun Shop. These were supposed to come out earlier, and we couldn't find them back there. So thank you very much. Happy holidays. I want to thank the cast tonight, Jay Malbro and Jenny. Victor and Diamond, are they here? Okay. And I want to get my co-chair up here, Mark Stratton. Where is Mark? Come on up here, buddy. Thank you very much. And I think if he's down by now. Andre, are you there? Andre, come out and take a bow if you can. Andre Cole & Company. In your sharing and giving with others in service. Thank you all. God bless you and good night.
Thanks, everybody.